As soon as you're born, they make you feel small by giving you no time instead of it all. Till the pain is so big you feel nothing at all. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. They hurt you at home and they hit you at school. They hate you if you're clever and they despise a fool. Till you're so fucking crazy you can't follow their rules. A working class hero is something to be.
So you're on side, huh? You're a concreter.
I'm on camera, eh? Yeah, yeah, I guess I'm a concreter today. So.
A working class hero.
Yeah, I love it.
You like it? Yeah. It's a part of your life.
What's that?
Is this the part you like?
Yeah, fuck yeah. It's the part of, you know, builds the building. Yeah, of course.
Working class man.
Of course.
That was the soundtrack I'm editing to. Working class man.
That's right. Working class boy.
So, this is the first time I've seen you on site.
Really? I'm here every day. How have you never seen me?
Have you seen me?
I saw you once yesterday, actually, but I saw you had your camera set up over there.
So what happens next?
So next, we're going to put the steel in over there, then we pour the concrete there, and then we build on this level, we pour all the walls and do all the interiors, well, not the interior stuff, but, you know, we do all the building.
You think you're so clever and classless.
Do the same on the other side. And then pour the slab there, and then pour the slab, and just keep going until we reach the top. So,
and what's the top?
The top's up there. So, we've got another 5 stories to go.
And each story is like this?
Each story is like this, yeah.
So, what is this process? Tell me what.
Well, this is the slab, right? So, this in a way holds the building together, you could say, but like, it's just the floor for
there's
each
room at the
level.
Top that
so, yeah.
Just the concrete. You're always putting all this metal there, and then you cover it all in.
The metal's for the reinforcement, makes the concrete stronger, you know. So the building's going to last an extra few thousand years.
What about the job of knocking it down in a few thousand years' time?
Oh, you know what?
Working class hero is something.
It'll definitely be hard. It'd be a struggle to knock this building down.
A working class hero is something.
The amount that goes into it is just, you know.
You don't realize.
Yeah, you know what you like. I feel as though when you've worked in construction long enough, when you look at a building, you don't see the building, you see all the intricate mechanics and you see all the, you know, you see it differently. It's like you just see the, it's like you've unlocked a new vision. You just look at any building, you're like, oh yeah, I know how they did that. And yeah. I tell you what, I don't know where we're up to, but it's probably fucking, oh, we've had heaps.
Make
sorry, I shouldn't be swearing.
Make
excuse
a leap.
Me. Pardon me.
Constantly.
That's what happens when you're on the job site for too long. You develop, you know, swearing habits.
Do you like working with the boys?
Yeah, I love it. It's great. Yeah. A good bunch of guys here, so. Good bunch of hardworking men, and that's, you know, what the world needs, you know.
So do you prefer there or up there?
I prefer it here. My job on this site, I just, you know, I'll just do all the odd jobs, which, you know, aren't very exciting. This is a bit of excitement, so it's good, you know.
How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand?
So how long have you been working on the job?
I've been concreting for 14 years. Yeah, sadly enough, so love every bit of it.
You do? Yeah. You still do?
Hey?
You still do?
Yeah, still do. Yeah, too mad in the head, I guess. I gotta keep going. So they're all concreters, they're just our little subby help-ins. Come in on the big pours to help us get it in.
Oh, it is washed to the sea. Yes, and how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? Yes, and how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind.
Hi. Yeah, bro. Are you in the bin? Watch out, come on.
Yeah, go like that.
Is that alright?
Yep, hold on.
Yeah.
Yes, and how many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? Yes, and how many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Concrete now, after a good day's work, run home, drink 20 beers. No dinner.
You slap the pokey to do, I reckon.
Yeah, that's the concrete is laptop, that one.
You can't forget the side hustle. You need the side hustle.
Where we go to do our invoicing. When they bring the pump over. And there we have it, a slap.
Beer time.
I got no wrap.
It's a short wrap, that one.
It's me, brother. I'm short and sweet. Unlike my pig.
So have you got more work?
This is a beautiful start to be caught in today at Manuka. Getting finished right now. Finished placing. The camera teams are running. Eric's just got a plan. Doesn't get much better than this, baby. Woo!
Yeah, the boys.
Yeah, the boys. got much the Tonga power, an Aussie power.
Much better.
PA power.
So what are the propellers doing? What are the propellers doing?
Helicopters? They finish it. They make it nice and hard. Yeah, it's a little bit. Nice and smooth.
Flat. That works on Australia.
So where's your next job?
Next job is... somewhere in town, Canberra, I think, maybe Taylor. Taylor, yeah.
A big job or a little job?
Another big one. Yeah.
So tell me about Jag.
About Jag? Yeah. We do a lot, mate. We've got the pump. We've got a concrete crew. We've got everything we need here. It's a one-stop concrete shop. And if you need concrete, we've got it all. Little jobs, big jobs.
So what's your boss? Is he a good boss?
Oh, he's great, mate. He's great. Gets in there. How's it go?
Every great bloke that we've come over
here. What about Angelo?
Angelo?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's alright.
He's alright. Yeah, he's alright. He's pretty good, isn't he? Yeah. He gets his hands dirty, doesn't he?
Oh, he loves it, mate. He gets in there. How's the red hot go? Yeah.
Pretty amazing.
It's alright. Yeah. I've seen worse.
So, we've finished the slab. This is the... first floor, and we've done the first half of it. So next concrete pour we do, it's going to be all of from here. It's going to be all of that. So I think the next one's going to be a little bigger. It'll be similar, but it'll just be a bit bigger.
And what's the process now? So what we've got here.
The process now. We've done all the formwork here pretty much. So now we just got to put a bunch of steel.
It's called formwork, is it?
Yeah, chucking the reinforcement. And then once all the steel's all fixed, then we're going to pour. And we basically just keep doing that on the way up. And as you can see down here, where those columns are, they're just going to go up all the way through the building. So here we're going to start building the columns and put a few walls around and do the anything that really involves concrete, really. So we'll do the columns, we'll do the walls, we'll do some other little bits and pieces. And then after all that's done, we start the same process on the other side. And then while that's happening, this level is going to be, they'll start doing the roof for that level. So roughly where that next story starts is where the next slab will, where the next story starts, that's where the next slab will be poured. And so on and so forth until we reach the top, so... Yeah.
And what happens to all the wood?
All the wood, that's my job. I have to handle that. Me and Marco are down there.
So what do you do?
We just carry it in wheelbarrows and throw it in the bin, which is down there somewhere.
So all this wood's there?
Yeah, all that wood. Yeah, that's all rubbish.
So you're going to take this...
Oh, but this wood here,
yeah.
The formwork here, the formworkers will come and strip that. So that stays with them.
So that's reused.
Yeah.
So all that wood that's been covered up now with concrete.
Yeah, all the wood there is going to get covered up.
We'll get stripped.
Yeah, yeah. Not the ones that are covered up. There's some wood there holding it underneath.
Yeah.
That'll probably come out. That'll come out first. Yeah. And along with all that other formwork down there as well, all those problems. My life goal is to expand the Leangus Empire to be as large as it possibly can be. Like, I want to continue the legacy. I've been born into this wonderful family and I feel like it's a real shame if I don't uphold my last name, you know what I mean? So they've done what they've done. I aim to quadruple it. That's the plan. And I hope my children will have that same mindset and so on and so forth, but yeah, that's the plan. I want Leangus world domination. That's the ultimate goal.
So you found someone to make the babies with? No, not yet.
No.
Not yet. Is it gonna be a good Greek girl?
When I'm ready to settle in my 30s,
is she a good Greek girl? It's gonna be, or
what's that?
Is it gonna be a good Greek girl?
I think she'll have to be Greek, yes.
Like your grandmother?
It's good, you know, having someone of your own culture, someone that's, someone that can truly understand and relate to you. So, yeah.
So what's the old man like? He's over there. Tell me about your old man.
Oh, he's over there.
Yeah, tell me about him.
He works hard, I'll give him that. Well, he works hard with the paperwork, but on the job site, between us, he's a bit useless.
Useless?
he's not that useless, but you know.
Compared to his paperwork.
He's a great man, my father. He's a very smart man. Smartest man I've ever known. So.
Really?
Yeah, definitely. See him giving instructions for all the workers over there. Hey, that boy over there.
Where I've seen his passion is his cars.
He's passionate, you know. And I believe he's passionate to continue this as well, so hopefully I aim to learn more from my grandmother while she's still alive. I aim to learn more from my father and yeah. Expand the Liangus Empire.
It's a tough game though, isn't it? Look, it's a tough. It's not for city slickers, is it? Construction sites.
I've always been on the building site my entire life, really. Because growing up, we were always building stuff, so I'd always be around construction. I've found I've quite enjoyed construction. I've enjoyed it much more than other jobs I've had. I've worked in hospitality, I've done a few other things. And I can manage, but it's not for me. I don't really like the indoors sort of, especially not an office job. I'm not a big fan of that. I like being outdoors. I like being hands-on, you know. It's just, I don't know. I feel like everyone's born for something different.
Yes, yeah. Sure. Oh, you're also born for the camera, too.
Really? I suppose. But yeah, everyone's born with their own unique traits and their own unique skills, and that's why the world goes around, you know. That's how God created us. If we're all born with the same traits, you know, what's the point?
Well, that
uniqueness is a very fascinating thing.
Yeah, but
everyone's unique in their own way.
I guess it's when, for me, it's when people in front of the camera don't stand up to it. They get fearful and they run away. Accuse me of things, you know?
Yeah.
You face up to it and you share.
Ah, that's beautiful.
And the beautiful thing about it is you'll have something you pass on.
That's right. Absolutely.
And you won't understand that until later on.
Yeah.
You know? So down the track when you look at yourself, you go, fuck.
You can post whatever you'd like with it.
So everything you've set up to date?
Yeah, everything I've set up to date, yeah.
Including what the one that makes blue movies?
Who's that?
The one that makes blue movies.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Upper-rated movies.
Ah, yes.